Hey everyone, what's going on? Joey here, and recently we posted an article about the farewell ceremony for the Golden Nugget Mine Ride. And that brought up a lot of questions. One, actually this one you guys have been emailing me all week is, hey, whatever happened to that GCI wooden roller coaster Wildwood was supposed to get all the way back in 2013? And so I figured, hey, why don't we go ahead and dive into what we can find out about it? Now, before we get started, make sure you subscribe, you turn on notifications, and you give this video a thumbs up. Let's get started. Back in January 2009, a young Joey Contino was already starting to record and preserve the history of the Wildwoods. It all started at the farewell party for the Golden Nugget Mine Ride.
Here we are, Joe and Nick Contino live on Golden Nugget, day of zero.
It was here that many Morey's Piers fans got a glimpse at a future roller coaster that would be coming to the Wildwood Boardwalk. Morey's built a wooden model of an unnamed roller coaster that would be something unlike anything we had seen in the Wildwoods, let alone on any coast in the world. This coaster would start on Surfside Pier and move under the boardwalk to the beach and over to the recently purchased Old Hunts Pier, or Dinosaur Beach, whatever you remember it as. Jack Morey himself was giving information about the ride, saying that it was designed by GCI, which is Great Coasters International, and would feature a lift hill that would sit at 110 feet. The lift hill would rocket you to speeds of 50 miles per hour. It would pull 4 G's and would include 3,100 feet of track. To put this into context, the Great White Coaster sits at 105 feet and brings you to speeds of 50 miles per hour at 3,300 feet of track. While at the time they didn't have a date on when it would come to the piers, in 2011, 2 years later, they released a press release out to newspapers, including the LA Times. At a cost of $12 million, the LA Times describes the ride experience as a twisting and turning coaster that will take riders through a series of zero-G camelbacks and extreme banked turns. For the finale, the train traverses a short bunny hop before plummeting into a tunnel that offers one last surprise dip. According to the article, Morey's had to remove the Golden Nugget and the Wipeout, aka Giant Slide, in order to make room for such a coaster. What made this coaster unique was, just like its sister coaster, the Great White, this would incorporate a hybrid model of half wood and half metal. One of the awesome features of the coaster would be the window. What I mean by the window is where the lift hill is, the wooden structure of the coaster would turn over into metal poles. This was created so that you can see into the pier from the outside like a window. Now, the LA Times article stated that this coaster would take about 2 years to build and could be completed for the summer of 2013. As you know by now, 2013 came and went with no new coaster. So what happened? We reached out to Morey's to find out, and sadly, we didn't get a comment. We did reach out to GCI, and the only details that they gave us was that Morey's came back to them in 2014 and again planned to have the coaster open by 2016. GCI goes on to say that there really wasn't much development on this coaster. While they were working with Morey's, they didn't even have a name for it at the time. We did learn later on that Morey's were playing with a few different names for the coaster, such as the Wild Woody and the Boardwalk Flyer. After that 2014 contact, GCI said that they never spoke to Morey's Piers about this coaster anymore, which leaves us wondering what would the coaster look like if it was actually built. And what is really cool is that someone actually thought of that and then decided to make a CG version of a point of view of someone riding this coaster so that we have an understanding of what it would have looked like on our beaches. Check it out. Thank you. unfortunately, there's a lot of loose ends, and because so many things were rumored, we couldn't really confirm much. I mean, to be honest with you, even at that point, as I said in the video, there wasn't even a name. I mean, you had the Boardwalk Flyer, which would be kind of cool, or the Wild Woody, which at that point, Morey's was working on another project with Wild kind of in it. They were working on the Grand Wild Woodian, which would have been a, well, we'll save that for another video because this is a photo of what it would have looked like. Yeah, definitely needs another video. Anyway, thank you so much for joining me. If you haven't done so yet, please subscribe, turn the notifications, and give this video a thumbs up. I'm Joey, and as always, I'll see you on the beach.